Private buffoon is a light-hearted loon. If you listen to popular rumor, from the morn to the night he's so joyous and bright, and he bubbles with wit and good humor. He's so quaint and so terse, both in prose and in verse. Yet though people forgive his transgression, there are one or two rules that all family fools must observe if they love their profession. And there are one or two rules, half a dozen maybe, that all family fools of whatever degree must observe if they love their profession. Jester, you'll need to consider each person's auricular. What is all right for B would quite scandalize C, for C is so very particular. And D may be dull, and E's very thick skull is as empty of brains as a ladle, while F is F sharp, and will cry with a cough that he's known your best hope from his cradle. When your humour they flout, you can't let yourself go, and it does put you out when a person says, "Oh, I know that old joke from me cradle." Early and tempers are short in the morning. An inopportune joke is enough to provoke him to give you at once a month's warning. And then if you refrain, he is at you again, for he likes to get value for money. He'll ask then and there, with an insolent stare, if you know that you're paid to be funny. It adds to the tasks of a merry man's place when your principal asks with a scowl on his face, if you know that you're paid to be funny. Here comes a bishop, maybe, or a solemn D.D. Oh, beware of his anger provoking. Better not pull his hair, don't stick pins in his chair. He don't understand practical joking. If the jests that you crack have an orthodox smack, you may get a bland smile from these sages. But should they, by chance, be imported from France, half a crown stopped out of your wages. It's a general rule, though you'll see that they quench. If the family fool tells a joke that's too French, half a crown is stopped out of his wages. Though your head it may rack with a bilious attack, and your senses with toothache you're losing, don't be mopey and flat, they don't fine you for that if you're properly quaint and amusing. Though your wife ran away with a soldier that day and took with her your trifle of money, bless your heart, they don't mind. They're exceedingly kind. They don't blame you as long as you're funny. It's a comfort to feel if your partner should flit. Though you suffer a deal, they don't mind it a bit. They don't blame you so long as you're funny.